We're just in front of the Arc de Triomphe. Behind that is the Champs-Élysées on a road just akin to the Champs-Élysées was where the attack happened. So I'd say ballpark around about three or 400 meters. And just to recap, as you said, that tragic event last night, one police officer killed, two injured, the attacker shot dead by police at the scene. ISIS claiming responsibility for that attack overnight. I asked journalist Christian Mollard this morning whether it would influence the election. He said yes. He said it would benefit Marine Le Pen and François Fillon. Why? Because they have the toughest stance on security and on immigration. Let's have a little look at what Marine Le Pen has been saying overnight. She said, quote, I am angry, went further to say the battle plan against terrorism begins by getting back our borders. Of course, she, Mr. Fillon and Mr. Macron, three of the leading four candidates, have suspended their campaigns for this final day of campaigning. It ends anyway at midnight tonight. The far left, Mr. Mélenchon, said he hasn't because the democratic process must continue. We've also been out on the streets, though, and asking voters whether the last night's attacks would change the way they plan to vote. Here's what they've had to say.
Terrorism is an issue for me, obviously, but it's not, well, it won't help voting.
I heard that yesterday some of the candidates were saying at the same time that they are going to remove some security measures in Paris. Well, this is not a good idea, so these candidates are out of the list for me.
My ideas are in my mind before the attack or after or during, and because we had a lot of attacks. So one more, it's nothing changed.
Overall, I'd say the tone of voters one of solidarity here in Paris more than one of fear. Either way, we should say that the betting markets and the financial markets, which are live and up to date, of course, they haven't really reacted to this at all. The polls aren't up to date to this. The latest poll that came out yesterday before the attack still has Emmanuel Macron in the lead, the centrist independent on 24 points, closely followed by Marine Le Pen, the far right candidate.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.